Hello everyone, this is Amita here. Let's start in 4 to 5 minutes more. Are you able to see my screen? Can you please type in yes in the chat window? Are you able to hear me and see my screen? Please type yes in the chat window. Hello everyone, are you able to hear me? Okay, are you able to see my screen? Please type in yes or no. Okay, thanks. Let's start in 5 minutes more. Hello everyone, good afternoon and welcome to webinar from Axalta Systems. This is Amita here. So before we start the webinar, a few things about logistics. This is a webinar for around 40 to 45 minutes and then we will take up the question and answers. If you have any doubts, any questions, if you are not able to see my screen, if you are not able to hear my voice, please type in the chat window. Don't unmute yourself, because if you unmute yourself, then all your background noise could be heard. Also, we might be thrown out of the internet because of the bandwidth issue. So please type in whatever you want to communicate to me from the chat window. So today what we are going to do is, today we are going to talk about Internet of Things and what are the job opportunities available, how the horizon looks in future. So this is what today's topic is briefly. I will talk about approximately for 35 to 40 minutes. Meanwhile, if you have any questions, you can jot it down. Then I will answer those questions at the end. So in the end, I have kept 10 to 15 minutes. During that time, you can ping the questions in the chat window and then I will take the questions. Okay. So again, welcome all of you to Internet of Things webinar from Axalta Systems. My name is Amita Mule. I am the technical training head cum business head with Axalta Systems. I take care of launching and overseeing all the training programs in Axalta Systems. So today's agenda would be, what we will do is first, quickly in 2 minutes, I will introduce about Axalta, our company. Then I will talk about what exactly Internet of Things is. Okay, I'm sorry. Few things about Internet of Things, and then we will look how Internet of Things look in future. how the complete horizon of job opportunities, career and everything, how it looks. Okay, so Axalta Systems is a company based out of Hyderabad. Axalta Systems is an IoT company started by two IITians who both are from IIT Roorkee. They have very good experience around 20 to 25 years in technology background. Till to date, we have trained more than 4,000 plus professionals globally, not only in India, but across the globe through various training programs like IoT Solution Architect, IoT Bootcamps, MQTT, IoT Protocols, IoT Platform Trainings, College Trainings, ThingWorks and other things. We have educational offerings, plus we have product and service markets also. So Axalta basically has two lines of division. One is Axalta Education or Axalta Academy, which deals with launching different kinds of career programs, starting from colleges, individuals to professionals, experienced people. I think somebody has unmuted. Please mute yourself. Okay. Also, we have recently started a technology training program for kids who are in college. It is called as Tiger Kids, wherein we have lot of interesting programs like Scratch programming using Raspberry Pi, Python programming using Raspberry Pi, making web pages, that is developing a website, Excel programming, all this for kids who are from 9 plus years of age. And this is quite correlated with the kind of syllabus today children are having in CBSE, ICSE or other boards. So these technology programs are for kids who are from 9 plus years of age. And the beauty of this program is these programs we run through franchisee mode. Till date, we have like 10 to 12 franchises across India of Tiger Kids. And we are looking to partner more people for this Tiger Kids franchisee. On the IoT product side, we have quite a good products in the remote sales management, remote security management. And we also provide IoT solutions, that is customized point solutions and services for the people who need to improve their business processes, increase their profit margin. We provide them IoT solutions. So if you want to know more about all these things, you can get in touch with us at corporate@axalta.com or you can directly email me at muli.amita@axalta.com. I will write down both the email addresses at the end of the session in the chat window. We have more than 30 plus corporate clients for whom we are the official training partners, and we keep on doing training on a month-to-month basis on different IoT technologies. Also, we have a program called as Center of Excellence for the engineering colleges across India. So what this Center of Excellence is, basically this Center of Excellence is setting up a IoT lab in the college, giving students training customized, for example, IoT embedded, IoT software, ThingWorks. So right now we have partnered with 10 colleges to provide this training. We have given technology trainings to different colleges like VIT Vellore, Oxford College Bangalore and also Crescent College Chennai. These are the few names. We have been ranked as one of the most promising IoT companies in India in CIO review, in Economic Times and also as top startup of the year. Axalta has a very strong team of more than 25 to 30 engineers who are from various backgrounds like embedded background, software background, testing, solution architect. So we have a strong team. We have quite a good industrial connects. As I already said, we are a corporate training partner for more than 30 corporates. So we have partnered with Microsoft, Intel, Tata Communication, ThingWorks and other companies so that we can provide you a good bridging of the knowledge from industry to your academics. Okay. Now, if you are aware of Gartner, Gartner is basically a research company which keeps on predicting the trends, what's going on. So Gartner has predicted that there are going to be 8.4 billion devices connected by 2017, and by 2020, 20.4 billion devices, that is Internet of Things or smart devices, will be connected to Internet. So what are these smart devices? These smart devices could be your connected car, your connected home, your complete connected hospitals, your street lights might be connected, your garbage bins might be connected. So by 2020, we are going to have 20.4 billion Internet of Things devices connected to Internet. And it is going to offer a 15 billion market opportunity for Indian businesses. They are predicting trillions of dollars of revenue globally in IoT market. So naturally, when so many devices are going to get connected to Internet and so much revenue we are expecting, world is going to need a lot of IoT professionals who will work into this area. So it is predicted that by 2020, 400,000 IoT professionals will be there in demand. That is, industry will need so many IoT professionals to work in different areas. So this is what we are going to explore today. Broadly, we are going to see what is Internet of Things, where are the pockets, where the opportunities lies, and how you can prepare yourself. Now, we have many participants today in the webinar, so you might be at different stage of your life, of your professional life. You might be an engineering student, you might be a fresher who has just joined a company, or you might be an experienced professional with 5 to 10 years of experience, or you might be a person who is well established in an industry who has like 20 years experience. But then this webinar is relevant to all of you, because the IoT is going to change the complete landscape of the industry. The way we do business, the way jobs are going to be there, is going to change entirely in coming next 5 to 10 years. Not only IoT, but different aspects of digitization. For example, automation, that is robotic process automation, if you have heard of, it is also going to create lot of opportunities. For example, if you have heard about BPO or BPS industry, they do a lot of mechanical jobs. For example, processing of insurance files, processing of your healthcare files, all these things are done manually. So all these things, when you make it rule based, all these processes, when you make it rule based, and when computer is able to do it, we call it robotic process automations. That is, they are called as software robots, which will do all these things. Yes, there are a lot of questions that might eradicate some of the jobs, but then there are opportunities that this might create a new job. Now, today we are just going to talk about Internet of Things and related opportunities. But one thing you have to understand, that the whole universe or the whole professional industry is going through a digitization phase. That is, everything is becoming digitally enabled. Either you call it IoT, either you call it automation, you call it e-learning, you call it digital learning. Everything is going through that phase, and hence the typical jobs that we have today may not exist after 5 to 10 years. Of course, they will be replaced with different kind of jobs and different kinds of skill sets. So that's what we are going to talk about, that what are the skill sets that you need to develop or you should keep an eye on so that you stay relevant in the industry and don't become obsolete. So we are going through industrial 4.0 phase. And here digital skills are extremely important. Now let's quickly understand in 2 to 4 minutes what exactly do we mean by Internet of Things, and how it is going to impact you and me. You might agree that as a human race, we think that we are the smartest people, right? Compared to other living things like plants and animals, we have made much progress. So similarly, we want to make our gadgets also smart, right? You must have heard about smart cars, smart homes, smartphones. So everything we want to make it smart or IoT enabled. Now, how do we make anything smart? Here are the few items in our ecosystem: TV, fridge, washing machine. Okay. So how do we make it smart? We give them an identity, right? We give them a unique name. This unique name could be given technically in the form of IPv4 or IPv6. So the people who are from technology, computers, electronics background might understand this, but other people who are not from this domain don't have to worry. But what essentially we are doing is we are giving it an identity. Once that identity is given, we need to give it a node. So node consists of sensors, short-term communication protocol, and this identity. So any device, right from your simple pen to your chair to your table to your electronic devices like washing machine, anything you want to make it IoT enabled, you should give it a node. This node consists of sensors, short-range communication protocol module like Wi-Fi, BLE, Bluetooth, ZigBee, Z-Wave, and a unique identification mechanism, which could be IPv4 or IPv6. Then, depending upon the kind of data you want to measure, for example, if I have a Fitbit band, I might be measuring how many steps I am taking, what is my blood pressure. If my fridge is there, I might want to measure what is the temperature, what is the humidity, right? If there is a sensor in my door, I might want to measure whether it is open or closed. So depending upon the parameter which I want to measure, I need to put the sensors into it. Then all this data will be communicated to a gateway. A gateway is basically an intermediate device which has one-to-many relationship with all the nodes. For example, if you have a smart or IoT-enabled home, then you might have smart objects like smart TV, smart AC, smart washing machine. All these things will communicate some parameters to a single gateway. And then this gateway will talk to the cloud. Cloud will store all this data and then analytics will be run on it. For example, if I have a washing machine which belongs to Samsung, then the Samsung might own a cloud which receives all this data. After analyzing this data, it can provide utility-based services like if your washing machine is going to fail, it might predict beforehand, right, which is called as proactive maintenance, and then provide a service to you. Okay, so this completes the entire end-to-end IoT cycle. Right. So when we talk about Internet of Things is not a single technology, but it is a amalgamation of different technologies. So starting from sensors, short-range communication protocols, node, gateway, cloud, and also big data analytics, everything comes under IoT. Now, the next logical question would be, why do we need IoT? Praful is asking, where is gateway connected? So gateway will be basically a device which will be connected to a cloud on one side through protocols like MQTT, HTTP, and on one side it will be connected to the node. So it does a dual purpose, receiving data from your nodes and passing that data to the cloud. Okay. Now once you have connected everything, right from sensors, nodes, gateway to cloud, then what we do is basically we do analysis of data. So if you have observed companies like Uber, okay, what they do is they get lot of data from this taxis who basically take people from one place to another. After receiving this data, they are able to predict what kind of traffic will be there at what hour, what time, what place, and in which city. And depending upon that, they can deploy their cabs at various places. And this is the advantage of IoT business. That is, by using real-time data, by analyzing this data, you can provide services to the client, and also you can use increase the quality of your product. This is the end-to-end IoT business. Yogesh is asking which protocols are used between Node and Gateway. Yogesh, generally RF protocols, that is radio frequency protocols like ZigBee, Z-Wave, Wi-Fi will be used between the Node and the Gateway, right? Now, if you look at this architecture, which starts from sensors to analytics, and if you try to apply it, we realize that this architecture of IoT can be applied to each and every industry. So any industry like medical, healthcare, home automation, your street light, smart city, connected car, everything can be connected to the internet. The data can be gathered and useful services can be provided to it. So you can yourself make out that IoT has application to each and every industry, right? Any domain you take any business problem, most of the things can be solved using Internet of Things or IoT. That's why IoT has such a big horizon. That's why I said initially that the entire landscape of every industry is going to change, because everything is going to become technology driven, data driven. As they say, data is the new oil, right? So as much as data you can gather, and if you can meaningfully find out the insights which helps your business to grow, then that particular company, that particular field is going to thrive. This is a simple chart which lists the different career opportunities, or rather the investment in IoT solutions by industry. Manufacturing has the biggest I can say use of IoT. Because if you talk about factories wherein there are a lot of pumps which basically make some chemical mixtures, or if you talk about factories like which make bikes, for example Harley Davidson, or if you talk about huge factories wherein some product is made, so all these manufacturing companies, their internal problem is that their factories, their machineries is so huge and so spread out over the acres that keeping track of each and everything is extremely difficult. So if some machine or some part or some process in your assembly line fails, then going and detecting it and then fixing it becomes a difficult issue, right? If you want to start and stop something remotely, then again it becomes a problem, because every time the person has to go start and stop. So all these things in manufacturing industry can be solved using sensors, wherein you have sensors which are sending the data and you are controlling everything with the help of either gateway or cloud. So manufacturing industry is going to benefit a lot from IoT, which we called as IIoT, Industrial Internet of Things. Similarly, every industry, each and every industry is going to benefit using Internet of Things. So as you can see, since every industry is going to benefit from Internet of Things, or everything is going to get digitized, all of us needs to get aware and also learn what is Internet of Things and how it is going to affect my career or change my career, and how do I stay relevant, how my job stays relevant, so that I can contribute meaningfully in the entire IoT ecosystem. Now this is a generic diagram. So as I said, the participants here today might be from different stages in their professional career. So when you talk about IoT as a knowledge, everybody doesn't require the same depth or same knowledge in IoT, right? When we saw the diagram, we realized that IoT is a amalgamation of lot of technologies, right? It is not a single technology like Java or maybe Oracle or maybe any other, right? It has lot of technologies, okay? Now suppose you are an engineering student, how much IoT should I learn is a question. Suppose you are a person with 20 years of experience and you are a domain expert in insurance industry, then how much IoT knowledge is sufficient for me so that I stay relevant? So these are the questions which might come to your mind. So that's what we are going to talk about today. So this is a generic diagram, right? So first and foremost, everybody should be aware of IoT as a concept. What is IoT, right? conceptually what does it mean? So you already know it because we have discussed it in the first slide, right? Whenever something, whenever any object, whether it's your industrial machine or car, whenever we want to make something IoT enabled, it has to have a node which has sensors, which takes relevant parameters, communicate through the gateway to the cloud. In cloud, we store all this data. We analyze the data to make the product better, to provide some services, or to remotely monitor, control, and maybe repair that device, right? So this holds true in smart cars, maybe your smart homes, in your healthcare systems, in your Fitbit bands. So this, you should be aware of this complete IoT ecosystem. Then IoT architecture, okay? So this also we have covered. IoT architecture, as I said, consists of a node, which will be there in your smart object. Then that node will communicate it to your gateway. Then the gateway will communicate to the cloud. And then the cloud will have different layers like reports, storing of data, connectivity. Communication protocols, sensors, IoT platform, analytics, database. So now all these four, 5 points which are written down, they are very specific. So the people who are technically involved, who are going to basically develop certain products, or who are going to act as solution architect or project managers, product manager, for them, all these things are very important. Now, suppose you are from a mechanical industry, you are from a civil industry, or you are from a healthcare industry, knowing these two concepts, like what is IoT concept, how it is going to apply to my industry, how my current job is going to change if my hospital becomes IoT enabled, how my current job is going to change if my factory becomes IoT enabled, and what I should learn so that I stay relevant. So for you, IoT concept, IoT architecture is sufficient. But for the people who are going to work in implementation, like developing IoT products, giving IoT solutions, giving IoT services, for them, the below 4-5 points are extremely important. Now, this is a reference architecture of IoT, which I will very quickly explain. So these are all the smart devices, maybe your mobile phone, your Raspberry Pi, your car, your connected fan, your connected home, connected street lamp. So all these are basically smart or connected devices. What these connected or smart devices have, they have sensors so that appropriate parameters could be communicated. They have unique identification, and they will be using some communication mechanism. Those communication mechanism either could be your RF protocols or your MQTT, HTTP type of protocols. Then all these data will go to your cloud, that is your IoT platform. There the aggregation of data will happen, the processing of events and analytics of that data will happen. After that, you will have different kinds of reports, that is dashboard, which will give reports to different users like management users, business users, developer, product managers, everyone, right? So this is the reference architecture of your IoT. Now, as I said, there are infinite amount of opportunities available. If you take any industry, take medical industry, take manufacturing, take water management, any industry can be made more capable, can be made more efficient if we apply IoT principles to it. That is, IoT principles, they enable us in giving the real-time view or real-time window of how a particular machinery or a device is operating, right? If you have installed something, then unless and until it becomes faulty, you don't go and repair or you don't go and see. This is the traditional product, right? In IoT, what we are going to get is, we are going to get the real-time data, real-time working of anything, and that is going to enable the quality of the product and the different services that we will be able to push it. So there are going to be n number of use cases, and that will generate infinite amount of opportunities for you as a professional, for you as an entrepreneur, if you want to make some products, if you want to give some services, and if you want to give some solutions. Okay, there is one more question. What is the difference between digital marketing and IoT? Okay, so interesting question. So IoT, digital marketing is basically marketing, right? So if I use my web page to market my clothes store, if I use Facebook, LinkedIn, social networking, Twitter to advertise my products, then that is called as digital marketing. So basically I am using digital media like website, social networking sites, your WhatsApp to market my products. That is a totally different area. It's a marketing. IoT is Internet of Things. It is a technology which will improve your business. Okay. For example, if you have a connected car, this connected car can auto diagnose itself. It will know that, okay, this part of my machine has failed. It will make a self appointment using cloud with the mechanic, and it will fix up an appointment and then immediately tell the user, this is the appointment for fixing the car on Sunday, maybe at 4 p.m. So this is IoT basically. Now broadly, there are going to become two, there are going to come two kinds of opportunities, or there are in the market two kinds of opportunities. So if you want to find a job, these terminologies may not be essential, but then these terminologies will at least guide you how you should prepare. Okay, so these two are IoT generalist and IoT specialist. So these are the two kinds of roles. Of course, in each role there are going to be numerous opportunities which are going to present yourself. Now, for example, if you are a domain expert in manufacturing industry, you know everything about machines, you know everything, how a particular machine operates, how do you switch off, switch on, if some part goes wrong, what you should do, what is the production, if the particular part fails, from where do you ship it. So basically, you are a domain expert in that industry. Now, if your company decides that since we want to make this processes efficient, since we want to increase the revenue, let's invest some money and make it IoT enabled. That is, put some IoT sensors into it, get the data, maybe remotely control all these machines. Okay, so that if something fails, we immediately know, go and fix it. Okay, now in this case, somebody from outside, a software engineer, an embedded engineer, is going to come study your plant and going to propose a IoT solution. In that case, you can be an IoT generalist, wherein you are a domain expert, right? But also you know how the end-to-end IoT ecosystem works, so that you can help the people basically to revamp your industry. So this is IoT generalist. We will see about this in detail in the next slide. What is IoT specialist? IoT specialist is a person who has a deep dive knowledge in a particular thing. For example, if I am a master of say 4 or 5 protocols like ZigBee, Z-Wave, I know how mesh network works, I know from where to buy the modules, I know what is the power consumption, how to write the code, I know how MQTT protocol works, which are the different brokers, how to develop a Java application. So these are the deep dive skills which are essential. So this person is called as a IoT specialist. Now, IoT generalist is generally suitable for the people who are deep into the industry, who have more than say 10 plus years of experience, who have a rich domain knowledge. So they can be a IoT generalist because they can retain their domain knowledge, and then this IoT can become a wrapper to their already existing knowledge. Okay. What is the IoT specialist? IoT specialist means if you are just starting your professional journey, if you are a student, if you have 2 years, 5 years experience, then you can choose some of the core capabilities or core skills which are in IoT and you can become a master in them. Now let's see what is a IoT generalist. What are the different options available? So as we all know, generalist means who has the knowledge of everything, but he doesn't have that much depth into a particular technology area, right? So jack of all trades, basically. So there are opportunities, lot of opportunities for IoT generalist. That could be application architect, IoT solution architect, IoT product manager, consultant, enterprise integration, okay, and even sales and marketing. Now the previous example that I gave, for example, Axalta Systems is a IoT solutions and service providers, right? Now, suppose a manufacturing company approaches us and says that, okay, we want to make all our plants smart plants, okay, so please give us a technology solution. Then we will need a person who understands the end-to-end process of a manufacturing company, draws a architecture diagram, says, okay, here we will put the sensors, here we will get the data, here we will analyze the data, and how this we will create the reports. So this person should be able to sensibly talk in the form of business, architecture, end-to-end flow with the manufacturing company. So this person could be IoT consultant, okay? He could be application architect, or he could be IoT solution architect also, okay? Other way around, let's take few examples. Suppose we realize that there is a lot of market for security. For example, in Hyderabad, there are a lot of jewelers or people who have locker in their home. Now, we recognize a need wherein we feel that if we IoT enable these lockers, wherein we get a detailed report of who opens this locker, at what time he has opened, what he has taken out, with a picture, okay, video and a picture, okay, and this has a good potential, we can sell this product. Then for such kind of jobs, we need a IoT project manager who would basically conceptualize this product, okay. From a higher level, he will understand what this product is about, how to retrofit the solution, what are the different levels or architecture points wherein it should be connected, how security should be applied. So this is a IoT product manager. Okay. What is the enterprise integration? Now any company might have different components of IoT, but which are not integrated. Okay, big companies like Cognizant, Infosys, they have different business units basically which work in silos. Okay, so you might have sensors which are giving the data. In manufacturing itself, you if you have the SCADA systems, okay, then they are like IoT itself. But then with the cloud coming up, you might need to push the data to the cloud and give a centralized view of the data. Then how do you integrate? So in that case, IoT enterprise integration person will be required. Sales and marketing. Now, not only domain experts, not only technical people, even sales and marketing requires this kind of IoT skills, right? Because when you market a IoT product is not a simple product which is based on technology, right? It will have sensors, it will have communication capabilities, there will be different vulnerabilities, different threats, how the security is applied. So there will be lots and lots of questions a person is going to ask. In that case, a sales and marketing person should be aware of how security is applied, what are the protocols, where I should fit the node, okay, where I should fit the gateway. So all these things are a part of IoT generalist. Now let's look at IoT specialist. Now as I said, we are going to need nodes and we are going to need devices, right? So in that case, we will need embedded engineers who are well aware of C, C++, industrial C, Python, okay? These are going to be the specialists which will work as IoT hardware engineer or embedded engineer. Then once these nodes are ready, we might need people who are good in connectivity, right? Who are capable of comparing all the different protocols like ZigBee, Z-Wave, Bluetooth, BLE, and then can give a comparative approach. IoT platforms, that is IoT architects, right? There are different platforms available like Microsoft Azure, ThingWorx, GE Predix. So if 10-15 companies say decide that we are going to use ThingWorx, okay, they will need people who understand ThingWorx as a tool, who know how to connect it to our devices, how to generate reports, Okay, so we are going to need people who are IoT platform experts. Data scientists. As I said, data is the new oil. So when we gather all the data in the cloud, only raw data is not of any use. We will need to analyze this data. We will need to prepare customized reports for every user who is going to see that data. And who is going to do that job? Data analyst or data scientist. Okay. So you can do courses like analytics. You can learn tools like R programming using Microsoft Azure package. Or there are different tools available like Tableau, Spark, which provides reports. So these are called as IoT specialists. Again, enterprise integration could also come in generalist and specialist, because this could also be a deep dive knowledge which requires everything. Development and DevOps means a person who understands technology and who also understand operations. So as I said, if you are working in a manufacturing firm and if you have good domain knowledge of manufacturing, and if you do say 10-day, 15-day IoT course wherein you understand the entire end-to-end IoT ecosystem, and in that case you can act as a DevOps expert wherein you combine the development technology and also the operation. So basically you will be the person who speaks to both technology side and both to process side, so that you can integrate those two to apply IoT. So as I said, all these technology and all these roles is a kind of hazy. I mean, still the industry hasn't boxed these roles like, okay, IoT device expert, IoT platform expert. But if you go to Naukri.com, if you go to other job sites, you will realize that there are some cluster of technologies which are asked. Okay. For example, on embedded side, now people have started asking about more about protocols like Zigbee, Z-Wave, LoRa, MQTT, CoAP. On the development side, for example, if you are a Java expert, people have started asking, you should know Java, you should know application layer protocols like MQTT, CoAP, XMPP, AMQP. Okay. If you are at the architect, if you are the architect space, then people have started asking the knowledge of end-to-end IoT ecosystem, IoT platforms. Okay. Yogesh is asking how Java professionals can get a space in IoT. So Yogesh, if you are from a Java background, that means you are into developing web application, desktop applications, or maybe mobile applications if you are using Android also. Now, if you want to get into IoT industry, first of all, you should be well aware of protocols like MQTT, CoAP, which are extensively used in IoT domain. Also, you should be aware of platforms like ThingWorx, which are completely Java-based and object-oriented, and which is kind of going to be a cherry on cake for your kind of a resume. So those are the two things we should be aware of. Also, if you are a Java professional with good experience in the range of, say, 8 to 15 years, then doing an end-to-end IoT solution architect course or doing a boot camp wherein you get a complete understanding of IoT ecosystem would definitely help. Now there are different big opportunities which are coming up in the middleware space. So as I said, for developers, product expert, integration, security experts. On the hardware side, node and gateway side, you should have the knowledge of boards like Arduino board, Raspberry Pi, Node MCU, BeagleBone, different kind of development boards. You should also have the knowledge of sensors, like how you should use sensors and extract the data. On the analytics side, as I said, there are different big data tools like Jaspersoft, Tableau, Mahout. You should be aware of these tools. And then NoSQL databases like Hadoop, and this thing. So these are the different levels which you should know. If you are a mobile developer, then you should be aware of Android, how you can use MQTT on mobile, right? iPhone developer. So protocols are going to be a major connectivity tool. So if you are a Android developer, Java developer, developing knowledge on protocol side is going to be essential, and second, developing knowledge on IoT platforms like ThingWorx, Microsoft Azure, GPredict is also going to come in handy if you want to enter into IoT space. If you are from a embedded or hardware side, you should know C, C++, Python, and protocols like ZigBee, Z-Wave, all those things. If you are in the range, like if you are an architect, project manager, product manager, solution expert, integrator, then having the knowledge of end-to-end IoT ecosystem, which piece fits where, what should be the cost, how it will scale up, all these things are essential. Now let's quickly have a look. As we discussed, there are going to be billions of devices connected to internet, and all these devices are going to be constrained. Like for example, if in a city I want to plant lakhs of IoT enabled street lights, then they are going to be then I need that those street lights consume less power. Okay, they have less computational ability, the cost is less, right? So in this case, you should be able to design a node wherein you use a minimum code footprint using C, industrial C. You use protocols like ZigBee, Z-Wave, RF protocols, and communicate that small amount of data either directly to the cloud or to the gateway. So these kind of things will be essential if you are a C programmer, Python programmer, that is coding in the constraint environment for power consumption, physical size, cost, using protocols to communicate the data, extracting data from sensors, how you will apply security, and then robustness. So all these things need to be critical if you want to be a specialist and if you want to code. Knowledge of sensors, if you are from a hardware side and you are good in development boards, good in using sensors, then what kind of sensors is useful for which domain, how the sensors react. So all these things are required for hardware experts. For embedded programmers, real-time operating system is very essential. Knowledge of development boards, protocols is extremely essential. So as I said, all these specialist and generalist job, they are not boxed yet. Capabilities and everything basically crisscrosses. Maybe after 5 or 10 years, once 5 to 6 years, once the IoT industry becomes more mature, specific jobs like IoT solution architect, IoT embedded developer, IoT Java developer might start coming up. They have started already coming up, but then they are not that in abundance. But if you look at the skill set which I am talking about, like communication protocols, RF protocols, IoT platforms, knowledge of sensors, cloud, knowledge of cloud, knowledge of big data analytics, then knowledge of NoSQL databases. So all these technical capabilities people have already started asking in their profiles. So first you have to choose yourself whether I am a generalist or whether I am a specialist. If you are a specialist, then you might require to add few more skills to your already existing skills and you can become a specialist. If you are a generalist, then you might want to do some IoT end-to-end ecosystem study wherein you understand how my industry, my job could transform by using IoT. Okay. Now there are a lot of IoT platforms coming up. If you remember the first diagram which I shown you, so herein we can very well make out that there are going to be billions of devices connected. All these devices are going to send the data, and then IoT platform is going to become extremely important. This IoT platform will majorly do three functions, that is connecting to the IoT devices, storing the data, creating reports, and then analyzing this data. So IoT platform is going to become an integrator or a glue to the entire end-to-end IoT ecosystem. So IoT platforms are very important. There are around 460 plus IoT platforms which are available in the market. But if you ask me, there are only 3-4 IoT platforms. ThingWorx has the largest market share, almost 28%. Others are like Microsoft Azure, Amazon, GE Predix, IBM Watson. So if you develop skill set over those platforms, if you do courses on those IoT platforms, as all the industries start becoming mature and start adopting IoT, everybody is going to need IoT platform to store the data, massage the data, display the reports. So having skills in any of the platform, that is configuring the platform, connectivity, having skills in these tools is going to come in handy. So IoT platforms again can be used either by a specialist or even a generalist. So as I said, for developers of Java, .NET, JavaScript, you can learn these platforms and also have some expertise on protocols. Then for product experts, if you are a product manager, if you have developed product in say digital industry or maybe manufacturing industry, thinking about how you can enable your product or how you can make your product smart, how it can be IoT enabled, will give you a boost to your career. You need not be a specialist here, only if you can envisage, like for example, if you are a manufacturer of a say or a pen, and if you can come up with a brilliant idea that how I can, that if I make this pen IoT enabled, and if the data comes to me on the cloud, what the person is writing, if you can communicate, if you can come up with such an idea, and then if you present it to the management, which increases the revenue, which increases the sale of your product, then definitely you're going to retain your job and progress. You need not be the implementer, because there will be different technology guys to whom you implement, but you should be able to dream, envisage about this particular product. Integration experts. So as I said, if you are from a PeopleSoft, SAP, or different kind of tools which are available in your company, legacy tools. So if you are from such domain, having the understanding of how your product can integrate with IoT enabled systems, what advantage it will provide you, will basically again fast track your career. By this time, you must have understood that there are different kinds of weak links in IoT. Since IoT is not a single homogeneous system, there are different kind of weak links. So security is a problem. So if you can become a security expert, wherein you understand each and every security aspect of an IoT link, then you have a good future. As I already talked about, you can be a specialist in cloud platforms, okay? Big data analytics, UI developers, mobile app developers, wherein you understand the protocols, wherein you understand the platforms, would also give you good boost for your career. Okay, so these are the different resources wherein you can check the Internet of Things job. Now what Axelta is doing in terms of training is that soon, by the end of next month, we are going to launch an IoT Solution Architect course, wherein we will give you a comprehensive program spanning maybe 3 to 4 months, wherein you will understand about all the different technologies and little bit deep diving into it, so that you are ready to architect, project manage, product manage a particular IoT solution in your industry. Also, we have a 3 to 5 day short boot camp for the people who are from different domains like mechanical, civil, sales and marketing, HR, who wants to understand about IoT, and if their company is going through IoT phase, they can stay relevant and make the necessary changes in their profile. Okay. If you are in a college, then we have Center of Excellence for IoT, wherein we go to colleges, establish a IoT lab, give training to students, give projects, and also help in placement. So if you are a student, you can take help of this. We have different certification credit courses for colleges, IoT embedded and IoT software. And also when we do all trainings, basically we provide certification. Okay. So we have a clear-cut Axelta certified IoT professional pathway, wherein you start, wherein you take up a course, give online exam, then you get a certification. We help you in resume building, and also we help you in placement services. So guys, this is all what I wanted to talk about regarding the job opportunities. If there are any questions, you can ping me in the chat window and then I will take up the questions. Okay, thank you. So I think there are no questions. So maybe I will shut off this session. Okay, Saurabh is asking, how do you integrate with cloud platforms? Do you provide free credits? Saurabh, it depends upon from platform to platform. For example, if you go to website, Osmosis, we do provide some free credits. If you talk about ThingWorks, Microsoft Azure, you need to go to their platform and check whether they give any free credits for connecting few devices. Sure, Simi, thanks. We keep on conducting this kind of webinars. Yes, Sumit, we have a corporate training and we have institutional training also. So we go to different corporates. We have also done training outside India, Malaysia, Singapore. So we go to colleges, we go to corporates for training. And also we do online training if there are single individuals. Yes, we will be sharing the recording with everyone. So as soon as this session is done, somebody from my team will email you the recorded session. Sure, the next webinars will be listed on our website. So you can keep on checking and have a look on our website. So we keep on listing the webinars. The next webinar is coming up on mostly in September, on 18 September. You can check the correct date on our website. It is about Exelta's solutions, Exelta's products and the different kind of services, IoT solutions that we offer. It is going to be a very interesting webinar which Exelta's co-founder Manish Agarwal is going to conduct. So if there are opportunities wherein you can partner, where this solution is helpful here in your industry, then this is going to be a really interesting partnership. Yes, Vinod, we do conduct training for incubator centers for startups. So for the specific requirement, please email me at mule.amita@exelta.com. I will call you and understand your requirement on a one-on-one basis and then we can take it forward. One more email address is okay, guys, so thank you for your patience and thank you for asking so many questions. If you have few more questions or few more doubts, you can get in touch with me at mule.amita@exelta.com, the email address that I have given, or corporate@exelta.com. Surely we'll be in touch and I will try to answer all your questions. Somebody from my team will circulate the recorded session to everyone who has enrolled for this webinar. So thank you so much. I will say goodbye to you now. Okay, bye folks.